Hi YouTube, so it is me, Elizabeth, aka Nurse Zabe, here on YouTube and Instagram, coming at you with another video. This video is going to be a little bit of a different video, and this one is going out to all my nursing student homies who are watching. Do cool people still say homies? They don't. That's okay. I'm sticking with it. Anyway, this is for all of the nursing students, and this video is going to be tips for having your best clinical ever. And this is for people who are going into their very first clinical, people who are going maybe back to school to do some more clinicals, just some tips on having awesome clinicals, because clinicals are exciting and scary and important and maybe your first step into the hospital. This video is all about how to have awesome clinical experiences. So if you're not a nursing student and watching this, hi, hello. I normally make videos about labor and delivery, postpartum, breastfeeding, all that fun stuff, and we will return to normally scheduled activities either later this week or next week, so do not fret. But if you are a nursing student watching this video or somebody interesting in nursing school, definitely go ahead and keep watching. So, I have a list of things that basically if I could like just let nursing students know, I would do that, because where I work we have nursing students, and first off, nursing students are great. They are learning, they are our future. Like, nurses, just embrace them because they are here and they are doing their thing, and you need to show them some love. But day in and day out, it is more work for us to have students. But at the end of the day, fostering these students and helping them learn is the best thing that we can do for the future of our profession. So the first thing I want nursing students to know is that nurses are human, and if you have a nurse who's a little bit grumpy, who's a little bit grouchy, like, do not take it personally. It is probably, I'd say like 99% of the time, not you. It is her or him, and we're human too, and maybe we're in the process of getting divorced, or maybe our kids are all sick and we're freaking out about childcare, or maybe we are just grumpy. And that happens, and don't let that negatively affect nursing for you, and don't think that's the norm, because I really truly believe that it's not, but just kind of remembering that. One thing that can kind of help if you have a grumpier nurse is definitely making sure that your nurse who you are working with knows exactly what your role will be very early on in the shift is going to be helpful in making sure that everything gets done, and different clinical instructors facilitate how their nursing students take our patients. More in labor, and we will have a nursing student follow us one-on-one, like they're like kind of like our shadow, they're our buddy, they're going with us and taking care of the patient. And then sometimes we'll have that they're just following one patient on postpartum, so they'll go in and help us care for the patient with them. And then the third way, and this would really only happen on postpartum, is that they are the main caregiver, and they and their clinical instructor are going to be going in and taking care of the patient solely while they're there, and then reporting back off everything that they do to us. And reporting off to your nurse at the end of your shift and letting her know what medications you give, what's been charted, and if there's ever a step along the way where you need a little bit of extra help, your clinical instructor is a great resource, but your nurses too. So making sure if you weren't able to do something, if you weren't able to give a scheduled med, for example, let your nurse know, because she's counting on you, perhaps, if you've told her that you're going to be doing these things. And you don't want things to be kind of left out in the middle if she's caring for other patients. She's also gonna be paying attention to what you're doing, but just open lines of communication, letting her know how you plan on taking care of the patient for that day, and also how you are going to be assisting her, either with her or with your clinical instructor, is really important. And then reporting off the end of the day, letting him or her know what you have done. So part of communicating with your nurse what you're going to be doing for the day, if your nurse asks you to do something that you don't know how to do, definitely verbalize that. Clinicals are not a time to go rogue and be like, oh, I've never taken out an IV, but I got this. If you don't know how to do it, let your nurse know and say, I would love to do that. Could we do it together? Could you walk me through it before I go do it? Or could I go find my clinical instructor and we do it together? Because I've never personally done that before. Another thing that is very, very important that I think all nursing students need to know about clinicals. This is probably my number one most important thing. And I have it written down, so I'm gonna read here word for word. Clinicals are about learning how to interact with patients and their families much more so than they are about doing a cool new procedure or technique. When you become a nurse, you will be taught how to start IVs. You will be taught how to do dressing changes. You will be taught how to monitor a baby. You will be taught how to do X, Y, and Z as appropriate to your clinical area in which you are working. But something that cannot be taught that easily and something that really needs to be worked on being mastered in nursing school is just how you interact with patients and other people, how you learn how to read a room, how you learn how to have conversations with people in a nursing setting. I really truly believe that that is what clinicals are for, getting your feet wet in the hospital, doing some observation, doing some procedures, yes, 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 but also learning how to interact with patients. And if you go in with that mindset and you are fortunate enough that you are really hopefully only caring for one patient, you can spend a lot of time establishing a relationship with that patient. And then you are getting better at working towards figuring out how to talk to people and how to interact with people of all different backgrounds, of all different religions and races and creeds and socioeconomic statuses, because pregnancy, for example, happens to everybody, and illness happens to everybody regardless of who they are. So learning how to interact with different people and learning how to best interact with those people, I think, is the most important part of nursing school. And that's the nugget that I want you to take away. I think that's what clinical really is all about. Along with that, offer and accept to do anything that the nurse needs help with. Be that removing an IV, helping with a dressing change. Bed changes are a big one that can be really, really helpful for you to do. And it's all about learning how to move a patient and learning how to interact with a patient. And yes, changing a bed is not always what we picture of when we pictured going to nursing school. We're thinking like chest compressions and cracking chests and doing all sorts of crazy CPR. But again, it's really all about learning how to interact with patients. And the more time that you're in the room interacting with the patients, the better you're going to be at this. Going back to clinical, so depending on what clinical you're in, you might be prepping the night beforehand. And obviously these preps are important because they are graded. But I think it's also important to make sure that you get a really good night's sleep before clinical. Don't go out partying or doing anything super crazy. And get to clinical early. Make sure that you have eaten some form of breakfast, whether that is a bar or a full 5-course breakfast meal with eggs and bacon. You do you, but make sure that you've eaten, because you might be in situations that you find a little bit unnerving, maybe some sort of dressing change, maybe a C-section or a vaginal delivery if you're on my unit, and you don't want to faint. You don't want to feel faint. But if you do faint or feel faint, you can still be a nurse. There are plenty of nurses who have fainted or felt faint or had to go sit down and sip some orange juice who still do great things. And maybe you find that whatever you witness is not the kind of nursing that you want to be doing. There are so many different types of nursing. You will find your niche. And just if you feel a little bit faint watching something, I have a friend who's a medical student. Actually, she's a resident now. In medical school, she watched a C-section and passed out. And guess what? She's still a doctor. She's just not going to do surgery. And that's what's going to work for her. So if you do faint, don't feel bad about yourself. But let's try and prevent fainting. So you're eating a good breakfast and bring snacks that, if you need to excuse yourself and go have a little snack before a procedure, before a vaginal delivery, before a C-section, you're able to do that. Remember, I mean, nurses, we eat all the time. So we love eating. Eating is important. And take a moment if you need to. Take a step back. Drink some juice and eat a little something, because you want to set yourself up for success and for not fainting. But if you faint, it's okay. Everything will be fine. So when you come onto the unit, I always recommend getting there a little bit early, figuring out where your clinical party is meeting, going there, meeting with your clinical instructor, figuring out your plan for the day. And then when you go with your nurse to get report, I want you to have a piece of paper and a pencil ready to go, or a pen, what have you, and I want you to write down report just as your nurse is doing. If they have a special report sheet, you could ask if they have extras. If not, just write it down. You're not going to get everything written down that the nurse giving report is going to say, because she's going to be talking really fast, trying to get out of there, and she may stop and explain things to you, but if she doesn't, don't let that stress you out. You can always ask for clarification later, but what really I find personally frustrating is when a nursing student is just sitting there, listen, and I know that you're listening, but like, write it down, take report. That's an important part of nursing. Another personal pet peeve of mine, and I know it's hard because nurses are not always the greatest example, but just stay off your phone. When I was in nursing school, if we were seen on our phone, we would get kicked out of clinicals. Now that doesn't seem to be the case, and I know our phone is a great tool for a lot of things, but because it's hard to clarify, like, are you on Facebook or are you looking up drugs, I would just leave your phone in your bag and not have it on you. It's an extra temptation that does not need to be there, and I know we as nurses need to be giving better examples of not being on our phone. I definitely have been guilty of being on my phone at work, but as a nursing student, just try and live by the rule, like, phone in your bag in a way. When you take a break and you're eating that granola bar, that's a great time to check your phone, you know, if you need to check your email, what have you. But just in general, have your phone away. Don't be on your phone. Be very present in the moment and be present in the moment with your patients and try to do as much as you can while you're there. Because clinicals, in reality, you really don't have that much time in clinical because a lot of times there's shorter or half days. So you're really just there for a few hours doing work. And so keep the phone away would be my advice and another personal pet peeve that we all need to get better on. So the final thing that I want to let you guys know about clinicals is if you have a nurse who is just doing an amazing job with you during clinicals and you're like, oh my gosh, like, here's an example. We have a nurse who works with us who is lovely and fabulous, and a patient asked her a question, you know, why are you checking my belly during your assessment? Why are you checking the top of my fundus? This was in postpartum. And the nurse had just explained what was going on to the student and why they were going to go in and what they were going to assess and why they were going to assess it. And she turned to the student and said, would you like to explain? And the student got to do that piece of teaching. And that resonated with the student so much. She said that's something that she will never forget. And you know how I know this is because the student then went and wrote a letter to our manager. And then the manager read about that in the staff meeting. And me as a nurse, who I do enjoy having students, but even somebody who maybe doesn't love having students would hear that and think, oh my gosh, that's a great tool that I've never thought to use with a student before. I'm going to use that. And so you sharing really good experiences with management that you have with a particular nurse is going to encourage other nurses to be better with students and to try and give all students really good experiences, and made the nurse who had already given student a really good experience, made her cry. Like, it was just so sweet and so amazing that nursing student kind of went above and beyond and really complimented the nurse, because day in and day out, it is more work for us to have students. But at the end of the day, fostering these students and helping them learn is the best thing that we can do for the future of our profession. So keeping all that in mind, it's always really nice when you get a compliment from a student. So if you have an amazing nurse, definitely give her a compliment. Anyway, that is what I want you guys to know about clinicals. I hope that the semester of clinicals goes great for you. Definitely let me know how things are going down below. I love hearing from the future of nursing. Bye guys.